morning. So this is Miss Chloe, and she needs a definite undercoat removal, and then we're just gonna probably shape up this coat a little bit. I'm gonna get her in the bath, and we're gonna get started working on this coat. The very first thing I'm gonna do is just get her wet, get her as saturated down to the skin as possible. There is a ton of undercoat that needs to be removed. It is extremely thick. So I'm gonna use some soap. This kind of works like a car wash. It's just a bathing system. You can see how fluffy this coat is right now. The goal is to remove all this out so we don't have to shave. This is a free groom. He's so cute. And get all that water down to the skin. I'm gonna turn it to just water, and I'm gonna use some of this degreaser. Just kinda get this coat a little clean. A clean coat usually releases that undercoat better than a dirty coat. This is not the final bath, just a help get some of that excess oil and stuff off. All right, now that that's rinsed, I'm gonna make sure this is mixed. This is conditioner, and we're just gonna use it to try and loosen some of that coat. I'm gonna saturate the coat all over. Really get it in there. A dry coat has a certain feeling. It feels very bristly. And we wanna make sure that we get the coat condition. That's gonna help release that fur. This just helps break up that hair a little bit. You can see it's coming out. This is my, what I call my bath slicker brush. You can see that coming out. And then we're just gonna use our nozzle, and that nozzle is just going to pull that hair out. She is gonna pull all that coat out. It's just dead hair that hasn't been shed appropriately, and it's stuck in there. Then go back to conditioner. I'm doing such a good job. It's already feeling so much better. All this in here. Can you stand up? I'm gonna get your rear. Just have some blueberry D-mat here. It's very matted on this chest. Just a lot of undercoat. Look down here, you can just see all that coat coming out. Does that feel good? Yeah. Okay, so this is filling up with water. I'm gonna scoot her back. Move this. And part of this is from the hair. That's being removed. Okay, now, what I'm gonna do, because this is pretty bad shape, I'm gonna get this everywhere, and then I'm gonna take my dryer, and I'm gonna blow it into the coat. I really want to save this coat, but it's pretty bad. So. Definitely messy. Can you see all that hair coming out now, though? It's working. That was the right thing to do. You can see all that hair coming out. What that does is it blows that conditioner down into the coat and kind of loosens that hair. Thank you. Okay, so I do a regular bath. Keep the coat clean. You can see how up here the hair is just naturally parting. We've gotten all the undercoat out. Back here though, you can see how it's still puffy. And up here, there's still undercoat in there.
Hi, you're so sweet.
I do super heavy conditioner with this conditioner. And then we're gonna start drying. And I haven't been including the drying process, but this drying process is gonna be pretty involved. So, I will show it. We're gonna use a bunch of Shosheen and hopefully be able to get all this out, but I don't know, back here is pretty solid matting. This is a super high quality conditioner by Nature Specialty. I just really, really, really want to make sure we're getting it in there nice and deep. Let that flow over the body real quick and just saturate that coat. Rinse. Still getting some coat out with the nozzle, which is great. Stand up, make sure all that's rinsed out really well, and we're gonna start drying. So that, all the hair we got out so far. I know, baby girl. All right. So we're gonna do a very, very, very heavy spraying of the Shosheen, especially where there's still hair that needs to come out. Do not spray this much on a dry dog. But that will just help cause slip. And then we're gonna put this on, fold the ears down, and we're gonna start drying.
Thank you.
So now, what we have to do is work on brushing out this coat. I'm gonna start with my small pin and then go to my longer pin. All right, baby. little bit of wine brushing, get that out of the chest. You're being such a good girl. Sweet. This is my mom's favorite kind of dog, a Pomeranian, so I'm gonna have to send her a picture when I get done. If I can get this all brushed out, we'll keep it long. But I will definitely tell them to come back in about a month so this doesn't happen again and get this bad. Hey. So I'm holding the hair so it's not pulling on her skin. That's when it starts to hurt. Some definite matting in here that we'll have to cut out. This longer stuff, I'm gonna use this one just to help separate it a little bit. Nope, up. I'm gonna line brush this brush. Up, up. Baby girl, I gotta have you stand up. You're okay, baby girl. It's okay. I'm gonna go ahead and do the sanitary so I can actually see what I'm doing. Some of this in here needs to be shaved because it's matted. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. Stuff you're not even gonna see. Shave the inside of the legs. Shave all this. Like that. Spilling. Because you won't even be able to tell that we shaved that belly. There, that's gonna have to be cut out. Just gonna separate it and then shave it out. And then once that hair goes back, you won't even be able to tell. Girlfriend, you gotta stand up. We'll start up a little higher. Nope. Baby girl, I gotta have you stand up. Okay. Thank you. keep looking over there and make sure my next client's not here yet. No, baby girl. All I'm doing is just combing this up and then cutting off just any of that fringe. It just makes the body look finished. No. being such a good girl. We're almost done. Okay. I think my next client's pulling in. So very quickly, I'm just going to do these paw pads. She'll be ready to go. And that's it. Damn, I'm all finished.